actually grew up on Sundays. I would watch black and white westerns with my dad, and so I knew about Wyatt Earp, and I knew sort of. I've always sort of loved that world. I'm really cool.
You watched westerns with your dad on Sundays. Yeah.
And
I'm being deadly serious, but
she is. And then I became an actor, and there's an easier way to answer it, but I want to tell this story. So then I took some acting class with some F-tard, who basically was like, women can't play, like, be real. Realistically, women don't play in this genre, because I had asked to do a scene that was sort of in this genre. And then this audition came up, and I was like, So, you know, it was the draw of the Western element and the fact that I'd get to be like Clint Eastwood a bit, you know? Like, I want to be Clint Eastwood.
You can call it a Clint.
I know, that's what he said.
Why am I fangirling over this?
For me, wow. I was in...
Ooh, me, yeah.
Nice. I was in London, and I actually auditioned for Winona first. Did you know that?
I don't think I did.
No, I don't think I've ever told you that. Isn't that weird? And I'm actually... I remember reading the sides and thinking, this is the funniest script I've read in a very, very long time. It was so witty, and it was a scene with dolls that in the script was called... something else beginning with D. Emily?
There was another name, yes.
Yeah, I can't remember.
I remember.
I can't remember. Anyway, and I did it with a deep South accent, so I really don't want to see that tape ever. I was
for
like,
Winona?
Oh.
For Winona.
I was like, oh, dolls, I don't know what's happening. It's terrible. So God knows why you asked to see an audition for Waverly, but maybe you forgot about it, and I was lucky enough to audition for Waverly, and it just, everything clicked into place. I was like, this is the coolest character. I pretty much see myself in her, so I just thought, if I get to play this role, it would just be the best, and I get to be a little bit of me, so yeah. And it all worked out really good, and they brought me over from England, so yay!
I also auditioned for Winona, and then I auditioned for Waverly. That's true.
Just the laptop, okay? I went for Winona too. Fuck it.
No, and then also, Tamara auditioned for Winona, and then Waverly, and then Nicole!
You can see how this is working, right? But I cannot imagine playing Winona. I can't imagine playing anyone other than Nicole. It's just like, now it feels like, what a weird fit. It's like pants that are super uncomfortable. But yeah, and I got cast like 2 days before I came. So they were already shooting the pilot, and then I came. And I came to the trailers, and Melanie, I met, was one of the first people I met. She was like, welcome to purgatory. And
you said that?
You did. So cool. This is adding to how cool you are. Yeah. yeah, and so I joined the ride in episode 2. It's been awesome.
Obviously, they're the obvious ones, but I think probably I would say meeting this young lady.
I think for Nicole, it's Nedley telling her that he wants to groom her to be sheriff and reminding her to be a good cop. And then it matters. Woo! That was a pivotal moment.
My favorite, it wasn't my line, but my favorite thing that kind of sums up season 2 was the past, when Bobo was Robert Swain, and he asked, what's my angel's name? And Winona responds, Waverly. I loved it. It literally put everything together. That was my favorite comment.
Yeah, Tim texted me, was like, you just wait, there's one line, you'll know what it is.
Yeah.
One word, he says.
Uh, I think Mel has all the great lines, in my opinion. Dalton's a straight shooter, as we know. Maybe the third season will have some fun puns and whatnot. But one of my favorite moments that Mel did, I think it was an improv, or maybe it was written, but it was still great. It was a belly bump high five.
That was really good. That was a writer.
Well, either way, it was a great line. And the thing about Mel, and even in this moment, I said, was it her? Was it the writing? Just because it shows how brilliant, you know, our writers are, and how Mel can interpret the writing and make it her own. And there's moments when we're on set, well, for me at least, and she's doing something. I'm like, wait, did she? What is that? Oh no, she's acting. Oh shit. Okay. You know, keeps me on my toes. So it's good.
Especially when watching it back, that scene with Mel and I when you first broke down about the baby. The line I say that's like, I'm not saying it's gonna be okay, I'm just saying that I'm here. I just think that's so powerful in how it's written, because you know, it's so true, and yet we, in life sometimes we pretend like it's gonna be okay, but that was actually the right thing to say in that moment, you know?
So. I want your boots. I like your boots.
Did I hit my head and wake up your patriarchy?
Yes, over here.
Thanks again.
Hello.
Hi.
Not the contact lenses.
Not the kissing. Just the freedom of Emily said it really well when I was talking to her about it. She was just oh god, I forgot what she said.
But it was very
so moving. Guys, I didn't get much sleep. I'm so sorry. Basically, it's just like, it was basically like, you get to see Wynonna if she was carefree, and she was having so much fun, and Wynonna's going through so much, especially this season, so you got to see Wynonna, like, at her almost purest in a weird way, and it was sort of heartbreaking in a way, but also just, that was the fun of it. Was to just be so free, and I got to be a bit mean. Sorry for the vegan line.
That was improvised, but
yeah, and it was so mean, and I felt so bad. I'm like, well, I think the demon would say that.
It was so good.
Yeah.
It was fun how it manifested itself differently in you than in me. I felt like I was actually a lot less free, like stiller and kind of stronger. Which was really fun to play, and as horrible as this sounds, but I was mean to you, but that was kind of fun in a way. It was like, because it's just so opposite, and that was, it's so cool to be able to play both sides of the coin, you know, and being like, ugh, yeah, it's you, and it's just like so different to what we usually play, so that was actually really fun. Don't hate me forever. Okay.
Yes.
Hi. I just want to preface this, Way Hot for Life.
Tim's audition, I mean, everyone's audition was amazing, but Tim's audition for Doc was really special. He was one of the only ones who wasn't imitative. He really made it his own.
I pay her to say this.
Do you have the tapes?
Oh, yeah. Awesome. I got them all.
I don't
want to
I read it, and I was like, man, I'm dying again. But I loved that I got to die in Waverly's arms. So, I mean, though honestly.
You have all the lines today, huh?
I loved it, but it was also so heartbreaking how good Emily is that I died in Waverly's arms, but I didn't have the relationship that Doc and Waverly had built to that point, because it didn't exist. So it was nice to die. I didn't get to die in the Waverly that Doc knows and has come to appreciate. So it was such a cool little moment. But Thanks for killing me, bro.
You killed me first.
I did not.
You did.
I didn't. I'm 211. I've seen it multiple times. Okay.
You're right. Yes. I just think whenever we have, when Tim and I have scenes fighting, you know, shooting, I think the fans really enjoy it. We enjoy it on set. It's always a lot of fun, and it's always a treat, but I concur with everything Tim said.
Thank you. I would want the power of persuasion. Here's why. Because I had a really smart reason. You got it. I remember. I said it to Jeff. I was like, okay. Because then it's not about the way you look. Like, I could persuade you. You know, like, a lot of times, oh, yes, this is so smart. because a lot of times, we're talking about acting, and a lot of times, as women, we get cast and we use our sexuality to persuade men, and it's so long. I'm like, are you sure? And he's like, yes, this is great. And I love the power of persuasion because it doesn't rely on your sexuality, it relies just on your persuasiveness, and fuck everyone. But I don't know what my name would be. It would be like,
fuck everyone.
Oops, I tipped you over. I don't know. Like, I could do something like that. I tipped you over with my words.
I have like the most unevolved answer. I really like swimming, so I just want to be able to breathe underwater, and I would be like, a swimming introvert.
I feel like it's the baby one.
Yeah.
And I feel like it's the in episode 6 at the end. But I think it's both of those because we're just there together.
Yeah. And then also you could go flip side and talk about like strutting down the corridor. Running around. There was a spider in the room and we were shooting, you know what I mean? There's so many funny ones as well that are also is good. But I must say, no, you go first. No, I forget. We're so tight. I'm so sorry. No.
Remember when somebody offered us coffee? We're like,
oh, yeah, we said no.
No, we needed it.
It might embarrass you, but whatever. We talk about this all the time, Varun and I, actually, because we are like the biggest Melanie Scrivani fans. And that's awkward, isn't it? No, but Mel has chemistry with everyone. I don't know if you notice this, but like when you watch anyone in a scene with Mel, they shine, and it's like the coolest thing in the world, right? So, anyway, I guess there wasn't really an end to that story, but that was no point. But no, so basically what I'm trying to say is anytime I'm in a scene, like the Earp sisters, like, I feel like I'm a better actor because of her, so.
I do feel that.
I feel that too.
Mine are the ones that they're, like, I love the Tacos Are Tasty episode. I like seeing you guys problem solving and really under the gun together. Like, it's just fun because it also makes me realize like we don't get to see a lot of these dual women badass scenes. So I love the heartfelt stuff of course, but I love as a woman seeing you guys problem solve together. Yeah.
But yeah, you're right, we have fun.
You know, like when you're tied to chairs and you're like press Siri with your heel and I don't know.
Yeah.
It's so fun and it shows so many other aspects of your relationship.
Bonus answer, I love the forehead kiss in the season 1 finale. Yes, over here.
Hi. My question is for everybody, and it can be completely serious or completely goofy, it's up to you guys. Mm-hmm. But what scene would you most like to have your character film in season 3?
Mm-hmm. Any scene.
And just any scene that you
write
want.
The scene. Like to write the scene?
Yeah.
I just want to have some scenes with Doc.
Me too. I'd love to have a scene where I slowly turn on the faucet and I fill up a sink with hot water and then I lather up some shaving cream. And I take out a nice straight razor.
I'll call that bluff.
And then I would use it to shave this eyebrow.
Use conditioner.
I would like to be in the scene with Officer Hahn.
I feel like this is why Emily does the writing.
I wouldn't say no to good old-fashioned body swap.
Yeah.
But like, I sort of wanna get inside all of you.
You know what they say, you may not go back.
Melanie, because she like doesn't give a fuck, but in the best way. Like she's so free, and I aspire to be a fraction as bold and free as she is. Because when you act, if you overthink stuff, you just sabotage yourself so badly. And Melanie's so good at getting out of her own way. At least it appears so.
Oh, thank you.
I aspire to that. Totally.
Literally, just make a boob joke.
What?
No.
the airport.
Where do you guys?
Oh my god!
You can do it all the
time! It's been bad.
I'm so sorry, guys.
See you in season 3. Don't get pregnant. Don't get pregnant. Don't get pregnant.
Guys, let's give Melanie Stefano a big round.
Scenes were the padded room scenes with Dominique. Not because they were hard, because I had the most amazing scene partner, but I was extremely exhausted because I was working on another project at the same time.
Tell the story.
And
the story?
I mean, I don't know.
I was shooting a movie at the same time as Wynonna Earp, so I was working from like 8 a.m. till 2 a.m. And then they put me in a car and drove me 2 hours to set to shoot Wynonna Earp. And
he gave it like 110% every day.
So I had zero sleep and working on the scenes with Dominique as we were shooting them. And we
on
just
a Saturday?
On a Saturday?
It was a Saturday.
It was
a because Saturday. We all came in because of your schedule, which was really...
I didn't know that. You worked on a Saturday?
Yeah, you're so cool.
Those scenes were difficult for me just because of exhaustion, but... I had her to rely on, and whenever you put us in a scene together, we kill it.
Yeah. He was just working with Liam Neeson, I think, right?
Yeah.
And then he came to me, and I was like, what? Sorry about that. But he was
just as good.
It was the scene where Nicole has read my DNA results. And it was hard because we were like all in fun mode and drinking and I then had to kind of turn and, you know, that shock when you're drunk, but it suddenly sobers you up, you know? And I wasn't drunk. So it was just getting that balance right of how much of it is like kind of shock and amusement. And I found that balance a little bit hard. It took a couple of takes, but I'd say that was probably the biggest challenge for me.
You know, I'm gonna say something that might be surprising. I sometimes struggle with how to play our makeout scenes so they're not all the same,
guys.
Like, I'm like, what can we do that's new? What have we not done? But I because I know.
You're gonna get a list. Now you're gonna get a list of things you haven't done.
Those are for so many people, and just making sure that there's this really nice balance of things you guys haven't seen before. I don't know, I'm always like, they're gonna get bored with this, but I know you're probably not. But I put a lot of my pressure on myself to keep getting those scenes right. Mm. Yeah.
Thank you. Dom and Kat jam session at Klexicon. If this can be answered, was the process like for creating all the content for Purgatory Case Files, and to Kat and Dom for creating our many beloved Way Hot video chats?
Aww, thank you.
We did those all in one day, the whole Purgatory Case File we did in one day. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to answer it quick. We did you were in one room, I was in the other.
It was really
room.
Weird.
We did the FaceTime. We did like
she was literally right there. And we're like,
yeah. and then we went to the booth and we recorded everything. It was one like ferocious day. So I'm really glad you guys liked it. I'm really glad it went over so well.
And big shout out to Georgie because she's the most talented
human.
She's
super talented.
And I love listening to her songs. Does everyone know who that is?
Yes, great.
TV obsession. What do you think your character's TV obsession would be?
Oh, I know for sure. I think Nicole, what you guys didn't get to see in the house is there's like all these great rock climbing things everywhere. I think Nicole's would be like watching adventure shows or National Geographic or stuff like that. Yeah.
Well, folks, be sure to give a big hand for our cast. Thank you.